Hi guys, Drew here once again for a ZCode System, and this week I want to take a look at some soccer games going on over in Europe that are some can't-miss games to watch and to bet on this week, and some games that will be very popular for bettors around the world. And once more, we're here to talk about soccer or football, whichever you prefer. And last week I just want to go back to a couple of the picks that we had in the blog and on the video, and one of which was Wolverhampton Wanderers against Manchester City, with Manchester City being picked to win. And yes, that happened on Monday evening in the Premier League. And also Liverpool taking on Brighton. That game ended in a Liverpool win, which was also picked by us in our video and on our blog. So guys, we've got lots of great information with our ZCode System VIP club, and we give you that through our videos and on our blogs. And if you want to stay up to date and get winning picks, then we recommend you definitely stay up to date with the VIP club and become a member of the VIP club, so you can get all of this great information, whether it be soccer, football, American football, that is, NBA, NHL, Major League Baseball when the season starts up again here soon. But we've got all the great picks for you. But right now, let's talk about some soccer action that's going to go on this weekend in Europe. And the first game that I want to talk about is a massive game going on in England, and it will be played in London at the Emirates Stadium, and that is going to be between Arsenal and Chelsea. And so I'm just going to go to the drop-down box here at the VIP Club main page here on the board, and we're just going to scroll down till we find that game. That game's going to kick off in the late afternoon, early evening in the UK, in the middle of the day, though, for all those lucky fans in the US who can wake up and just watch their football while they're having breakfast or brunch. And there we go, the Chelsea versus Arsenal game at the Emirates that'll be played on Saturday. And as you can see, we've got two teams with a bit different form going into this game. Chelsea here is burning hot going into this game, and winners in their last match against Newcastle United. Arsenal average down right now. They lost at the weekend to West Ham, a bit of a surprise loss that was. They have only won twice in their last six games, three of those games ending in losses. And once again, they are conceding goals. The defense has not been shored up this year by Unai Emery, despite the team doing well in attack. These two teams did meet earlier this season, with Chelsea coming away as 3-2 victors in that game. And as you can see, Chelsea has gotten a result in the last four matches against Arsenal, with two of those ending in victory. Over the course of the last six matches between the teams, Chelsea have picked up three wins and only lost once to Arsenal. That came back in 2016 with a surprise Arsenal 3-0 victory there at the Emirates. But as I said, Chelsea doing very well against Arsenal. Chelsea currently in fourth place, and they're trying to hold off Arsenal from overtaking them for that Champions League spot. Now, I think this is going to be a very good game, just like the one they played earlier this season. But much like that game earlier this season, Chelsea are slightly the better team. They're conceding fewer goals than Arsenal. And for me, Chelsea are going to come away with winners in this game. Arsenal, as I've said before this season, a very good team with a lot of promise. I think this is a team that could contend for a Premier League title next season once they are a full year under Unai Emery. He just took over last summer. I still think this team needs some more players, especially in defense. And Chelsea are slightly better right now. Chelsea going to win this game on Saturday and doom Arsenal to another defeat, their second straight. Now, let's take a look at a game being played in Spain this weekend. And that is going to be the game between Sevilla and Real Madrid, which will be played at the Santiago Bernabeu in Madrid. So we're just going to go to our drop-down box, and we're going to scroll down until we find this game, which kicks off in the afternoon in Spain. And there it is right there. Another lovely time for the North American audience. This will kick off in the early morning at around 10 o'clock. Madrid going into this game, average up right now. Sevilla burning hot down. Sevilla, although they have only lost once in their last six games, this is a team playing a bit inconsistent football right now. Only two wins over the course of their last six games, as you can see here. They lost last time around to Athletic Bilbao. Now, that is a bit of a damning loss, because Athletic Bilbao is fighting relegation right now in La Liga this season. But Sevilla also a bit disappointing in the fact that early on in the season, up until around Christmas, they were fighting for the La Liga title with Barcelona and Atletico Madrid. They have really fallen away. They're 10 points now behind Barcelona, and really all they're going to need to be able to do or hope to do is to hold on to a Champions League place in the top four there in La Liga. Moving over to Madrid, as I said, average up. They've lost two of their last six games, which they're still suffering mightily from selling Cristiano Ronaldo last summer. They still haven't replaced him. Obviously, they're looking right now in the January transfer window to find a player to come in and score some goals for them, because that's what they desperately need, and they need that consistency, which they haven't had all season. But as you can see, they won last time around against Real Betis. Unfortunately, though, they lost away to Real Sociedad the week prior to that, and a draw the week prior to that with Villarreal, which these are games that Cristiano Ronaldo-led Real Madrid would have easily won. Now, let's take a look at the head-to-head between these two teams over the last few meetings. And as you can see, the most notable thing here is the home team has won each of the last six fixtures. Sevilla, yes, they have won the last two games they've played against Real Madrid. And look at those goals scored against that Real Madrid defense. But as you can see, the home team has won, been favored in all these games to win. And I think this is going to happen once more when these two teams meet at the Santiago Bernabeu on Saturday. I think the home team, Real Madrid, will take this match, win all 3 points, and once again move up in the table. These two teams are third and fourth currently in La Liga. Sevilla third, Real Madrid fourth, and both tied on points. Madrid get the win. They're going to move over Sevilla. I think Sevilla peaked early on in the season, and right now I think they are suffering, and I don't really see them holding on to third place in La Liga, and I see Madrid taking this win at the weekend and dooming Sevilla to another loss. Now let's take a look at one more game this weekend happening in Europe, and I want to look at England. I want to look at a team that has really come on strong as of late, and that's Manchester United. Now, Manchester United really suffered early on this season under Jose Mourinho as coach. The team wasn't playing very well, but suddenly they have really turned it on. They've won six matches in a row, and a lot of people are seeing this Manchester United team as really achieving something that a lot didn't earlier on. Even people, pundits are thinking that Manchester United will be able to beat Paris Saint-Germain once the Champions League rolls back around. And if you'll excuse me just a moment, just looking for this fixture that is taking place on the weekend as we go back through our drop-down box. We're going to find Manchester United, who will be taking on Brighton at the weekend. Oh, there it is. We skipped over it a couple times there. But Manchester United will be hosting Brighton at Old Trafford Stadium in Manchester. And as you can see, burning hot right now, Manchester United winners. And that is five games in the Premier League. They also won once in the FA Cup under new manager Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, a club legend. A bit of a surprise win over the weekend for me. I expected Manchester United to lose to Tottenham, who had been playing very well and who had beaten United previously in the season. But this is a team that is now recovered from how they had played earlier in the season. They're more attacking than they were. Players are playing in slightly different positions, including Paul Pogba, who has been fantastic since Solskjaer has taken over. Brighton, they were losers last weekend to Liverpool 1-0. A very shaky game for the league leaders, who did come away with a win thanks to a penalty. Brighton doomed to a loss there. They have only won once in their last six games. And of course, United winners of five straight. Let's look at just the head-to-head real quickly before I give you my pick for this game. And as you can see, they've only met three times over the last 18 months, with the home team taking the win each time. Manchester United, though, in these two games here, last May and in early August, this was a very different team, very much struggling. I expect Manchester United to come out guns blazing in this game and to really take Brighton by surprise, if you will, because I think This Manchester United attack is so much better than it was back in August. I do expect to see goals scored in this game. I wouldn't be surprised to see over 2.5 goals scored with Manchester United taking the win over Brighton in this game at Old Trafford. Now, guys, of course, you can get all of these great selections for this weekend's soccer action at the ZCode System VIP Club. All you have to do is sign up and you can get all the great picks for soccer, whether it's baseball, NHL, NBA, NFL, you name it, whatever sports you like, whatever sports you want to bet on, you'll be able to get that great information and those picks, and you won't have to do all the due diligence and all the work yourself. Now, also, guys, you can go over to the ZCode System website, check out the blog, see all the information. You can see my latest blog right there, the soccer predictions for January 19. I've also previewed a game from the Argentine Primera Division that will be played on Saturday between River Plate and Defensa, a big game down in Argentina. I didn't talk about it in the video, but you can go to the website, you can check out the blog, and you can get that information and bet on that game. Perhaps you might want to have a lovely little threefold going for the weekend's action, and you can use those picks to win yourself a nice sum of money. Guys, I hope you have a great weekend with all of your betting. I hope you watch some great soccer action from across the pond in Europe or down in South America. And I hope you have some great profits rolling in. See you next week, guys. Thank you.